They're expensive these days for a penny.
Yeah. Hiya. How you doing?
I'm a vintage person, I'm not old.
Where's me sausage? Here you go. Hang on. My name is Ian Prowse, and I'm here today to do the Cavern Asks series. I'm gonna answer these questions. Pele or Maradona? Well, you might think I'd say Pele because my first band was named after Pele, but I'm actually gonna say Maradona because I do believe he was the greatest player of all time. And there's a song about him on our brand new record called Diego. So yeah, Maradona for me. What was the first song you learned to play? It was Something Better Change by the Stranglers. It's only two chords, but it was, Stranglers were one of my favorite bands when I was a kid. So there you go. Who's your favorite new act? Well, it has to be the band that I consider I was the midwife. I gave birth to them, and it was here at the Monday Club as well, and that would be the Red Rum Club. The lads came and played here every single Monday for about 6 months. Well, they learnt their chops. So yeah, I brought them into the world. I gave birth to them. If there was one song that summed up the Monday Club, what would it be? It has to be Hide the Sausage. The famous sausage song. There you go. Hang on. It's got to be Hide the Sausage. The Southbound Attic Band and Barry Jones, who wrote it, as far as I'm concerned, have been a central part of this whole thing. And they've glued every single edition of Monday Club together by having that song in the middle of the night. And I'll never forget the sights of people who walk in halfway through to hear an entire room singing the chorus. And they don't know what they walked into. It's a profound part of our club. Where's me fucking sausage, you bastard? Where's me fucking sausage, you bastard? I was hoping to enjoy a lovely saveloy. Now where's my fucking sausage, you bastard? Profound. There you go. Who would be in my dream supergroup? Oh, Jesus. I'd probably just like to be all the members of The Clash, but now Joe's not here, I'll be Joe. So Mick, Topper, and Paul, and that would be my supergroup. And maybe we'd get Clarence Clemens in on saxophone as well, to the side, from Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band. So yeah, there we go. What is the one thing you can't live without in your dressing room? Bottle of brandy. gotta have a slurp of brandy when you come off stage after giving it everything you've got. I like to have a little brandy as a little treat for myself. The more expensive, the better. It's my only moment of bourgeois acting. What is your favourite Monday Club memory? Oh, Jesus. Do you know what? There's been so many. I have seen things that you people would not believe. running a club in a city centre, and one as popular as the Monday Club, I've seen everything. I've seen the best acts, the worst acts, the rudest people, the nicest people. To pull it down to one memory, maybe that time that a French band from Martinique came in, 14 of them asking to play, and we managed to get them up and play. We had them all up on the stage. And the great thing about the Monday Club is that when something happens which is really unusual or interesting, the Monday Clubbers react and everybody goes crazy. And we had it last week, and an indigenous band turned up from Mexico, and everybody just took to them and took the roof off. So and every single edition is different as well, as the locals will testify. So yeah, that's probably my favorite memory. What's the first thing I would do as Prime Minister? I would do two things. I would ban private education and private health. That's what I'd do, because I do believe that both those things should just be free at the point of entry for all of us. And if we did do that, then they'd be both be at the very highest standard within a year, because the people with the money would make that the case. So, and I think the like in Finland at the moment, which they're basically doing that, I think it would help the betterment of the country, the spiritual health of the country would improve immeasurably. And the hand dryer is agreeing with me. There you go. I do know for a fact that whoever the new Prime Minister is that they're picking at the moment won't change anything for us ordinary people. If you could have one act, dead or alive, to play the Monday Club, who would it be? Oh. I think it would have to be John Lennon, just because of this street, you know. If John was to reappear and sing here on this street, and I wouldn't expect anything less than three of his rock and roll songs, you know, because he always said, didn't he, that the Beatles were at the best when they were playing in the Cavern in Hamburg, when they were just being a raw rock and roll band. I think that would be the best thing, you know, the most emotional thing. Tell us about the importance of the Monday Club and what it means to have it in the Cavern. Between myself and the Cavern and the people who come to the Monday Club and the act, it's like the perfect storm of greatness. Because when we began it, they asked me to do it, and I was kind of like, I'm not so sure. And then we hit upon an idea that it wouldn't be a straightforward open mic, and it's not a straightforward open mic. It's a, you know, we have the equipment set up for full bands, so bands can just get up. We have poetry. We've even had a play on there once. We have comedians. As long as it's creativity, anybody can get up and do it. And I think setting up that rule of no cover versions is instrumental. But also, because it's the most famous club in the world, we have a free flow of people coming in and out from all over the world, mixing with the locals. Mixing with the local musicians. And because I know everyone, we get loads of really well-known musicians and songwriters come and play. We've had Miles Hunt from The Wonder Stuff, Damien Dempsey, Dr. Robert, Lee Mavis has been here. The real people have come and played here. Hurricane Number One, Ian McNabb. We've had everybody come through here. So between us all, I think is what's made it easily the best night like this in the country. And the most legendary, and it's the Cavern have been right behind it from the start. So yeah, I'm very, very proud of it, and I've always treated it with great respect. You know, when I first started it, I probably needed to do it for the money. You know, I needed the job. Rosie was about to be born, and it was fortuitous that this arrived. These days, I don't need to. My music career is doing well enough. I don't actually need to do this, but you just try stopping me. I absolutely love it. And we've just done a tour with Elvis Costello, and every night I could get home to do the Monday Club, I'd travel through the night to get here, because I love doing it, and it's very, very special to me. So happy 11th birthday, Monday Club. We're going to get to at least 20, promise you. Thanks for listening. Oh yeah, I've got an album out at the moment, One Hand on the Starry Plough. And we do a big show at the end of the year. We're playing in the main room at the O2 Academy. We had over 1,000 people in last year. And we have a 14-piece band. And people who dig what I do come in from all over the place. And you're on the guest list this year. So yeah, do come to that. Thank you.